And it goes a little like this. Come on, listen.
In a little bit, so I said, sorry, y'all. Ooh. Okay, my light back here. I mean, because, you know, that's Jesus light. You see that God? It's just God right there. You see? Good morning, guys. Amen. Happy Sunday. I haven't did a praise and worship video or a message video. And so I said, you know what? Let me do it now. I'm feeling in, well, I'm always feeling in the spirit, but I'm feeling real good. My hubby's up here. A family that prays together stays together, okay? That's number one. I need my little... my little baby's in here, but nah, not right now. But anyway, so he has his Bible. He's in it. He's entering into the presence of the Lord because that's how he's gonna be able to deal with his wife. That's how he's gonna be able to deal with his children. That's how he's gonna be able to deal with his own demons. That's how he's gonna be able to deal with our demons that come along. That's how he's gonna be able to fight this. And this is how we're gonna make a successful marriage. Okay. So all the ones that's trying to save their marriage, get into the word.
They say go through Jesus.
All the ones that's trying to find a man, get into the word, okay? And when you're looking for a man, you know, make sure. Of course, money is important. Education, class, character, all that's important. But if you make sure that he's sent by the Lord, make sure he's covered with the blood of Jesus, make sure he's a Christian. Well, he can be whatever race you want. I'm a Christian. Make sure he's a whatever y'all you are. I'm a Christian, so make sure he's a Christian, okay? Because therefore everything else will be added to him. Amen. Everything Amen. Else will be added to him. Amen. Okay, so when you look on a date and y'all talking about eating at the Cheesecake Factory and y'all eating and you be like, okay, on y'all first date, what you like, who you is and this and that. Make sure you get an understanding with him that I serve the Lord and see where he go about it. And then you'll have a good old husband because I'm not just married. See, you got people that's just married and then you got people that's married, okay? I'm married. I'm that one. I have a very happy marriage. Yes, we go through our ups and downs, but I ain't got no man knocking me upside my head. Hey! Be quiet and clean your room up. I don't got no... sorry, y'all, with my light. Let's see here. I don't got no man. There we go. I ain't got no man knocking me up against my head. I ain't got no man cheating on me, not coming home. I ain't got no man who don't, you know, shed no money. I don't have all that craziness that people got going on in their relationship. What are y'all doing? Who are you talking to, Jewels? Why are you telling her to open? What door she got closed?
Well, she got the door closed.
What door? Zariah. Why are you in the bathroom?
I'm cleaning.
Okay, Jewel, she's cleaning it. Go sit down, Jew. Or go clean your room up, Jewels. Sorry, y'all. Okay. Yeah, so it's different to have a good marriage. You know what I'm saying? And the only way I see a person can have a good marriage is a person who is three of y'all. You, him, and the Holy Spirit, and God, and Jesus, and all of that. That's the only way I know. Okay. So anyways, we're going to do a beautiful praise and worship video today. All right. I don't know who, what sermon we're going to listen to, what message God wants us to hear. But right now, we're going to do some praise and worship. So the songs you're going to hear is some, a couple of me and my hubby songs that we like to, you know what I'm saying, get ready to hear the word in. You know what I mean? So, and if you guys want to know any of my songs that I'm playing, now this light may irritate y'all because when I'm praying or when I'm entering in the word of the God, of the Lord, I like to have my windows open. I like to see, as you guys know, I live in Vegas, so I'm surrounded around mountains. And so I like to see mountains when I'm, ooh, my light, hold on, y'all. See, oh, can't see nothing right now. But anyway, those are all little mountains right there. It's kind of cloudy right now. But anywho, and so with that being said, I like to have all my windows open. I like to have all of light, God's light shining in. It just lets me know how real God is. And I just like to feel it. I like my whole house to just burst with the blood of Jesus. So that's me. So it may be a little, you know, lighty, but oh well. Okay? And if y'all want to know the songs that I'm playing and y'all like them, then, I'm going to put it right here, then put it in my comments down below. Make sure you like my video. That brings other people so I can be able to get a coin. I can't get a coin, y'all, until y'all like my videos. I got a part and y'all got a part. Y'all part is to comment in my comments and to like my videos, okay? And if you want to share them, you can. What else? And if you guys know any good gospel music or any good pastor that you think I haven't heard or you think I would like, share it down below. That's caring, y'all. We need this at this time right now. We need this. I'm going to be doing a couple of sound offs. I got a couple of things I want to talk about after I listen to my word. It's three things that's going on in the world. You guys know I'm from Los Angeles, California. And I live in Carson, and Carson is very close to Hawthorne. So rest in peace to the boy who died. I know people are not showing him love right now from Hawthorne because, number one, he was a gang member. Number two, he spray painted on Nipsey's mural because he's a blood. And a lot of people don't care about the human part of him. And I just want to give a shout out. I don't know who watches my videos that is from LA, but he is still, no, he was 21 years old. He's a kid. We learn, we make mistakes. You know what I'm saying? He probably wanted clout. People do all type of crazy shit for clout. You get what I'm saying? Not only that, he wasn't even the one who sprayed it. But anyway, that's why you got to watch who you kick it with. So rest in peace to, his name is Indian Boy Family. I'm going to talk about it on my sound off after this video, okay? But I'm going to put him up in my prayers. I'm going to put his family up as I'm worshiping. Rest in peace, the little girl in Texas, the 16-year-old who jumped out the car after arguing with her mom on the freeway, who passed away. Mm. Rest in peace to her. These are all the deaths that have just came by, you guys. And who are we if we hear about these things and don't pray about them? You get what I mean? That could have been my daughter, that could be my cousin, it could be your daughter. You understand? I don't know what the situation was. I don't really care. God knows. I do know the mother is gonna need healing. I'm a mother, and if I seen my kid open the door while I'm going on the freeway and jump out and die, that's heavy on a mother's heart. That's heavy on a mother's heart. So make sure you guys please put her up in prayer. I don't know her name. I will have all my facts when I come back. But as I'm in this worship, I have to worship and help, you know what I'm saying, build strength. Because prayer work, you don't have to be close in order for a person to feel or have something work over their life. That's not how prayer works. God is everywhere. And so I want to give her a shout out. It was one more death. The boy, oh, the building, 200 people accounted for, 73 people, I think, died. They're looking for 63 more people now in the dust or whatever. Rest in peace, all of those people. Rest in peace for the family members that have, cover them, Lord. Give them strength for the family members that have to go and identify their body, find out that that was one of their people. That was rough. All of these deaths, all these different things that's going on in the world, y'all. I mean, y'all got to connect to something. Something is in the mist. Something is in the air, okay? Something's in the air. And if you know where you belong, catch up with your right crowd. See, I belong here. And you know, and back in the days, maybe you could, fadiggle and fadondo with the Lord and do that and still. No, not in these times right now. These times right now, you better hold on to something powerful. Because that's all you got.
Amen.
When kids are opening the door because they are, her and her mama was arguing. The little girl opened the door and was willing to kill herself. She killed herself. Okay? I have never heard of things like that in my life. Buildings just crashing down because the building, the super, didn't take care of the situation. I mean, can you imagine? I live in a nice story home. I live in a home. I don't even live in an apartment. I can't even imagine this motherfucker just crashing down on me and my family.
But the Lord gonna cover us.
So you must be covered. You must protect yourself. And we must send out these prayers to other people and what's going on in their world, y'all. If I'm going to look at the news, if I'm going to entertain that and hear all that craziness, I got to be able to pray for these people and pray for situations and pray that something changes and some things going on. Because I don't like this, y'all. I don't like it. Anywho, listen to your word. Do your praise. Do your worship. Don't get caught into all of these things and be safe. Be safe. We gotta learn how to deal with our children differently. Something about that girl, either she was scared of her mama, something was going on. I don't know, okay? I don't know. But her mother was on a freeway. Not on the street. On a freeway. And she opened the door and jumped out. And a car hit her. And we're gonna call out for that car to come. That car, don't be scared, car. The car is a hit and run. You know, it's not really a hit and run because the girl opened the door, okay? But the car was scared and nervous. So we got to call out for that car. We're going to stand behind that car. Because that was something, too, to know that you helped, you know, this baby with the suicide when you really didn't, but you kind of did. You get me? That's a heavy, too. People are laying right now with weights that they have never can even comprehend. That could have been me on the freeway. And I hit a girl that opens the door. It could be you. We got to figure something. And she's black. Not saying, yeah, I know, but I'm with my black. If she was a black girl, black people don't do this. When have kids ever got that scared of ass whoopings that they would open up a door? If that's the case, I don't know yet. They ain't say, just said a dispute. With the mama. They ain't said what it's about, this, that, and the other. I ain't went on her Instagram, and, you know, the family ain't really came out yet and said nothing. So I'll be doing my research on that. But the whole point of the matter is we maybe got to parent our kids different. You know what I mean? Right now I got something going on with my boys. My boys are fighting one another. They're fighting. I have one that's terrorizing everybody in the house, okay? And it's upsetting me. And so I told them, don't do that no more. This and that. If you do it again, this is what's going to happen. Today, they wake me up with the bullshit. With the bullshit. Immediately, I want to go the fuck off. Because I already told you what was going to happen if this shit happened. I mean to be serious. You understand? They both telling me what happened. I listen. I have an oldest one, the one that's going on 9. And then I got a 6-year-old. 5 going on 6. And so they're tussling with each other. They both have hit each other. They both are not listening to what my instructions. One of them is lying. The other one is telling the truth. It's just a lot going on, right? So my blood told me to, my blood, just my, the meaning, my natural part of my body told me to fuck everybody up. Just fuck them up. Put them on, make them lay down, okay? Put them on punishment, and that's it. Then the other part of me said, don't do that. Don't do that. Pray about it. I said, pray about it. This ain't nothing to pray about. I can handle this. This right here, I can handle. And the Holy Spirit said, no, pray about it. I'm like, well, I can do this right here. I can fix this problem. I promise you, I'm going to whip their ass and we're going to be all good. And the Holy Spirit said, no, pray about it. So I said, okay. So now I'm in my theater and I'm praying over it. And we have angels that helps us. Okay, find your angel that help you. Gabriel, Archangel Gabriel, or Gabriel, however you guys want to say it, is one of the angels. I'm going to call him down to help me and guide me. Because I could not listen to my Holy Spirit, right? And it could be something else in the back end of what the fuck's going on, and I have no idea. So either I can make it worse or I can make it better. And I am a very new parent. And when I say a new parent, I mean a new parent. I have never been around kids, so I have some. I don't know how kids operate. I have been, when I tell you, I don't even have cousins, y'all. I have been by myself without kids, know nothing about them. When they do things for the first time, it's the first time for the both of us. Okay, so thank you. I don't want me to tell them not to whoop each, not to kick each other's ass, and then here I come whooping their ass. Hitting and hitting equals hitting. What type of shit is that? So I don't know how to deal with it. Okay, I got many ideas. Something is another part of me said, go get some boxing gloves, put their ass in the heat, and let them do it the right way. Because they're boys. They're going to have arguments. But if I teach them now the important way of how to settle their arguments, then maybe they won't hurt each other. Maybe they'll know how to fight properly. Because I can't say they're not going to fight at all. They're so close in age, they're siblings. And they're with each other every day. Every day. So I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to get back. If you guys have any suggestions, you have boys, let me know. Put in the comments down below. If you got an oldest one who thinks he's goddamn king, okay, let me know. And if you got a youngest one who loves the oldest one so much that he don't even know this is a goddamn fool, don't watch him, you know. So I got a lot going on when it comes to that. But God told me, don't whoop him. God told me to pray about it. And that's what I'm going to do. Give them to the Lord because they're his kids. These children of ours are only lent to us. It says it in the Bible. They're lent to us. So we must do the best job that we can do. And if it takes me to stop to evaluate some things and figure out what's best, what works for mine, that's what I'm going to do. I don't have to follow the norm. I don't have to follow what people do. I don't have to do none of that. Especially people that don't have, ain't even with the fruit that I'm even trying to get my kids to go to. What I've noticed is people, kids, that they tell me, they have a lot of respect and they say they kids and they whoop the kids' ass, but what do your kids do right now? I want to know that. I want to know, what do your kids do? Have they been to college? Do they know about God? Do they live the righteous life? Do they help at the homeless? I just want to know. You've been knocking your kid out for 10, 20 years. All I want to know, what your fruit? What's your fruit look like? Because maybe I'm not trying to get what your fruit got. Maybe I don't want a kid that's afraid of me, that can listen to me, but don't do well in life. The whole purpose is they do well in life. That's the purpose, and listen to me. So let me try my way to do it the best way that I can, because I want fruit. I want good fruit on the tree. You understand? All right, bye.